Hello, Women's Giving Circle. My name is Rebecca Pettit, and I use she, her, hers pronouns. I am the Development Director at the Missoula Interfaith Collaborative, or MIC. And thank you for the opportunity to share work with you all today and for all of your work and support in the community. For those of you who are unfamiliar with MIC, MIC has been operating for about 10 years in Missoula, and we live out our mission with four signature programs. Common Good Missoula is a diverse network of 35 institutions, including faith communities, neighborhood groups, unions, and nonprofits who believe that health and well-being throughout our community requires everyday citizens, particularly the most marginalized, to be meaningfully involved in creating the solutions that shape our community. Common Good Missoula trains leaders in the skills and practices of community organizing. Missoula Works and the Get It Done crew finds and supports meaningful employment for individuals who may experience barriers to employment. Missoula Works places individuals at local businesses with a temp to permanent staffing agency model, as well as provides employment through our full service Get It Done crew. Family Promise, an emergency housing program for families, is currently operating out of the Family Housing Center, located at the YWCA's Meadowlark. Family Promise volunteers provide meals, overnight staffing support, and family and housing supports to the families at the Family Housing Center. And finally, our Housing Advocate Network walks alongside individuals and families in the community, at the Family Housing Center, and returning from incarceration who are experiencing houselessness. Advocates not only provide support in identifying resources and housing options, but their presence means that their very daunting task of identifying permanent housing doesn't have to be done alone. In this work, we recognize a significant gap in our housing supports in Missoula, supporting people before they needed emergency housing. Fortunately, we received funding support from Family Promise National to fund a diversion specialist position, as well as to distribute funds. In September, we hired Ruth Guthrie as our diversion specialist. I'm going to turn it over to Ruth to talk a bit more about the diversion program.
Hi, my name is Ruth Guthrie. I use she, her, hers pronouns, and my title is the Housing Advocate Program Coordinator. I also work for Family Promise as the Diversion Specialist, and I'm here to talk a little bit about what diversion is and how our program operates. The diversion program that we're currently operating empowers individuals within our community to make decisions for themselves about permanent housing. We assist them in limited financial assistance and in creative problem solving to help them move into permanent housing solutions that work for them. So these are case-by-case solutions that are tailor-made for individuals in our community who are homeless or at risk of experiencing homelessness. We try to have long-term relationships with those folks. It's built into our program to stay in contact for at least 6 months just to ensure that the solution that we've found with individuals is working for them, and also to figure out where we can expand and improve our program. Our hope is to expand our current service group from families to individuals and families. One example is a client that we have currently who has a child in juvenile detention who is trying to be reunited with that child. As at present, we can't serve that person because their child is not within their custody, but with this grant, we hope to expand diversion to allow us to serve people who may or may not have children within their custody. So that's one example of how we hope to expand the program.
Thank you, Ruth. Currently, we have grant funding from Family Promise National to support Ruth's position until March of 2022. It's really important to us to divert families and individuals from emergency shelter when we can. And we know that the success of our program depends on having somebody who can provide that support, that brainstorming, and a little bit of funding in order to help people stay in their homes. So thank you for the opportunity to share the work that MIC is doing in the community, and we look forward to partnering with you in the future.